like to present this morning yung isang additional na arrest natin with in relation to the planting of IED doon sa may Baywalk sa Rojas Boulevard last November 28 this year. So this is in relation to the relentless manhunt operation of the NCRP, or particularly the Manila Police District. The name of the other suspect is Muhammad Umaw'as, alias Modi. He is an X-ray technician sa isang hospital and a resident of Santa Ana, Bulacan. He is also a Balik Islam, kagaya ni Rajid, yung na-aresto noong November 30.
Okay.
So, itong taon na to, kasama siya doon sa pag-surveillance. We were able to get a copy of the CCTV camera doon sa may luneta. So, nandito silang tatlo on that night, Sunday night, while conducting surveillance, kung saan nila pwedeng iwan yung IED. So, this series of footages, makikita natin dito, naglalakad sila doon sa vicinity ng luneta, na kung saan nila gustong ilagay una yung IED. Nandito silang tatlo, naghiwa-hiwalay sila, hanggang nag-proceed sila doon sa Baywalk, doon sa Rojas Boulevard. Okay?
Sir, pwedeng pumungo yung suspect.
So, ang na-recover natin sa kanya is one caliber 45 and one hand grenade. So, he was already charged of illegal possession of firearms and illegal possession of explosives. Are there any questions?
First question can come from Mr.
After na ma-arrest yung si Rashid sa Bulacan, nagtago siya. No? Nagtago siya. And he thought for a while na akala niya tapos na yung operation. So after na nagtago siya, then pumunta siya sa normal ano siya, pumasok siya sa hospital, pupunin niya yung staff na because he is an X-ray technician.
Sir, may additional background ba tayo itong tao ito? Kailan siya dumating dito from Marawi? Isa may ba siya ng dalawa?
He's not from Marawi. He's a resident of Bulacan.
Pero
part of the cell. Yes, part of the cell that is being used by the Mindanao group, the new group. Yes, sir. He's part of the cell now operating in northern part of provinces, Bulacan and nearby provinces, in support of the group of Ansar al-Khalifa in the Philippines.
He has long been here in
yes.
Yes,
he is. But based on information, he has been traveling to and from different places in the south.
Sir, hindi naman sa recreate tayo ng tao. Ano po yung possibility ng mga ibang pangkatulad niya na nandito na isang tawag lang pala from people
from Mindanao, it can
insect.
Well, number one, we all know that they are developed to one cell, no? Since nung umpisa pa lang, alam natin na ito
yung mga
they belong to one cell and they're about mga lima sa grupo nila. So we're still up going after two of their members.
Henry
Atulan from
CCMF.
Sir, pati sa camera.
Next question
from
Henry.
Sir,
hello.
Sir,
how are you, sir?
Facebook ka naman, nakikita ka naman sa Facebook account siya. Sir,
his full name is Muhammad Umaw'as. Muhammad Kumaw-as.
Kumaw-das-as.
Hindi yung double A-double-S, ha? A-A-S.
Yes.
Kumaw-das-as.
Kumaw-das-as. Sir, sir, pwede bang i-elaborate niyo, sir, kung paano talaga siya na-aresto? Kailan siya na-aresto? Saan siya nagtago? Para kami, sir?
Nagtago siya doon sa Bulacan-Bulacan. He never left the place, actually. After the arrest of Rashid, he never left the place. Nung nakita niya na na-aresto siya, no, nagtago siya. And then after, nung namaglal, akala niya hindi na, wala ng follow-up operation, that's the time na kinuha ko, kukunin niya sana yung ano, kukunin niya yung mga gamit niya doon sa hospital. And he's about to flee. No? Doon na siya na nakuha ng ating mga operatiba.
Kailan yun, sir?
That's about December 3 na huli, December 3.
Thank you, sir.
Okay na. Ruel Perez from Inquirer Radio.
Sir, anong participation niya dun sa pag-iwan ng IAD?
Kasama siya dun sa grupo. Kasama siya dito sa tatlo. Remember, nandito siya, ito siya.
Yes, sir.
Part sila ng casing dun sa luneta. Nag-iwan doon sa IED. Ito siya.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, sir. Sir, may info tayo kung paano naging miyembro ng grupo itong mga to. Kasi parang may trabaho naman siya, sir, di ba? Paano sila na-recruit?
Well, unang-una itong mga to, balik, Islam ito. No? Or kasi maging convert ka. May mga indoctrination yan. No? And then they'll brainwash you. Ganun lang ano yan, parang kang lumilipat from one religion to another. So you have to believe on what their religion says. Ganun yun. Kaya yung radical mentality, talagang yung bago ka i-convert, kasi parang magiging yung thinking mo magiging radical. Kaya ganun. So, you see, yun yung ano dyan. Kasi there is indoctrination. Remember, from one religion to another, bago ka i-convert dyan, merong indoctrination.
Sir, gano'n na sila katagal na member?
4 years. Around mga 4 years na.
Dong, buka. Dong, bisa sabihin ko rin. Magtatanong ko ito, magtatanong. Magtatanong ka. Leo, buka.
Sir, nakita ko kanin ko yung suspect sa investigation. So, parang may mga nare-review na ba?
Yes, they're very cooperative. Pat Rashid have already nagbigay na siya ng extrajudicial confession in front of a assisted by a counsel. No, sinabi na niya lahat yung nalalaman niya. Meron na siyang sinabi na niya itong mga grupo niya, kung well, yung iba medyo confidential, no, yung sinabi niya. That's why we still have follow-up operations and we expect most probably, hopefully, makuha natin yung isa o dalawa pa na sinasabi nila kasama niya based on his confession.
Is this a cause of alarm? Kasi parang nakakapag-establish sila ng isang senso. So far, isa pa lang, baka meron pang iba pa pala.
Well, ito ang ginagawa natin. No? That's why we are on full alert. No? Isa yan. That's the main, isang reason yan kung bakit yung nga sabi ng ating GPNP is we are on high security threat level. So that our target hardening measures, which includes, no, yung intelligence gathering natin, yung counter-terrorism operations natin, ay hindi-strengthen natin. That's the main reason kung bakit tayo naka-full alert, especially the PNP. No? And of course, sila kasi na-monitor natin. At there are intelligence operatives that are monitoring yung mga ganitong grupo at yung kanilang mga activities.
Sir, isa na lang po kay Colonel Cornel. Sir, you mentioned a while ago about Facebook sa suspect. Paano naging helpful yung Facebook parang
aras? Part of the investigation process we made is checking with social media. They know that they are using Facebook and other platforms to disseminate their information. And that is why we're very fortunate that he is registered as a user. That's why we can verify his status and his activities. But of course, we have to check this with our informants on the field. And based on the investigation, we were able to establish his connection with this group of AKP.
So yung sa CCTV muna siya na-identify bago nyo na-analyze?
He was, his name was already part of our persons of interest at the time that we were conducting the operations. And at that time, we did not find out that he was still in Bulacan. We thought he was one of those who already left the area. But then our informants in the field and follow-up operations showed that he was only hiding. And that's why on December 3, we were able to arrest him while he was retrieving his property's belongings from the hospital and bound to flee from there.
Last question from
Mr. Rizzo.
Sir, regarding
the status of Facebook, what exactly has been like
does it
also
include other members of the
wedding
members?
Una-una, makita mo yung pictures niya. Makikita niyo yung pictures niya. In fact, you can see some persons there now who was also part of our investigation. And there are other information which would rather keep it classified at this moment pending results of our follow-up operation.
Pero sir, based on your
but apparently, this is the first time there will be blast to conduct such mission. Yes, as planned by the AKP group in Mindanao. And you will be able to find out in his Facebook account that he has associates or linkages with persons from the county from Southern Philippines. So we're exploiting that information.
Sorry, sir, follow-up now.
That's a possibility we're considering. But at now, we have established that they are connected with the AKP group, Ansal Al-Khalifa in the Philippines. So we'll find out in the coming days if we'll be able to arrest the other members of the cell.
Thank you.
George Sahilis
from CNN.
Good morning, sir. Sir, good morning. Sir, ano nangyari dun sa two remaining suspects? Payments na ba? Or yung initial information natin na nakipagbakbakan sila with Northern Group? Na-confirm na ba natin yun, sir? Or
yung two other suspects, they're now subject of our follow-up operations. Hopefully from today until tomorrow meron tayong maging output dun sa follow-up operations being conducted by the elements from NCRTO.
But they're still in Mindanao, sir.
Yung isa sinabi nga nila na bumalik, no? Yung isa sinasabi nila na bumalik immediately because na-recall daw because of the offensives being conducted by the Armed Forces of the Philippines versus the Maute group dun sa may Marawi, no? Pero yung isa, we believe na nandito pa sa either dito sa NCR or nearby provinces, Cavite or ano, yung adjacent provinces dito sa NCR.
Sir, kanina kong mga may nakuha ng parang pending ID sa Manila. Meron bang connection ito, sir? Or maybe sa series ng mga threats dito sa Metro Manila? Or are we
at around 6:10 in the morning today, two street sweepers again discovered a suspicious package at University de Manila premises in Trumugos. They brought this package to the Manila City Hall and attempted to surrender it to our civil security force and City Hall detachment, thinking that this might be a contained explosive device. And from there, our City Hall detachment called our EOD team, our bank technicians, who responded to the area, and upon rendering safe procedures and disruption, they found out that it was a bomb hoax or a package which was designed to look like an improvised explosive device. So it was, it poses no danger at all from the very start. We were able to recover certain portions and parts and which we're trying to investigate right now. Who planted that bomb, possibly as a false alarm to divert attention or maybe to as a bomb scare. So that's subject to investigation.
Subject yes. of investigation. Sir, the street sweepers brought those bombs yes. using their hands. Yes.
Yes. That's what is scary actually. That what was scary. No? Kaya nataranta yung mga tao dun sa, no, sa city hall. No? That should have not been the case. Kasi dapat hindi niya ginalaw yun. Kailangan sinabi lang niya sa kapulisan natin yon and then let the our EOD K9 to clear that item, no? Mali yung ginawa ng street sweeper this time, no? Unlike totally different dun sa ginawa nung ano nung nauna nang ni-report niya yung nakita niyang suspicious item. This one dinala niya. Dinala niya dun sa City Hall kaya nataranta yung mga tao dun sa City Hall.
Part din ng education natin sa public.
Yes. Yeah, that's part of ano, no? Kaya nga inuulit-ulit natin sa public, sa ating mga kababayan, na if ever na nakita silang anything suspicious, any item or any bag, naka-box, anything suspicious, huwag nilang galawin, no? Pabayaan lang nila, leave it there, and then just inform the authorities, no? Or the PNP personnel dun sa pinakamalapit na police station.
Okay. Sir, again, titingnan pa natin kung pwedeng interconnected itong mga bagay na ito.
Yes, part of the investigation.
Alright, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other questions related? Wala na po?
Wala na ma'am.
Okay, you can proceed to other matters.
Wala na, thank you. And more. Isolated case lang naman yung mga yan. I'm sure hindi siguro kung talagang legitimate yung police operation, I'm sure walang intention yung ating PNP personnel dyan, no? However, that will be investigated. No? Kung meron talagang pagkukulang yung ating kapulisan dyan, I'm sure they will be punished or met with administrative punishment and penalty, both criminal at saka administrative.
Sir,
sa operations like here in Metro Manila, no, ang arrest na nangyari na dito sa Metro Manila is around already 12,000 na. 12,000 na for the past 5 months alone, no? Yung kill dito is like only around less than 2,000. So that's just about 5 to 6% dun sa nahuhuli compared dun sa nahuhuli natin. So this is a very small percentage kung compare natin dun sa nahuhuli talaga natin. No? Hindi siguro yung killing rate na sinasabi ko, it's not true. Kasi this is just about 5 to 6% of compared to the arrest na nagagawa dito sa arrest rate dito sa NCR.
Sir, you may or may not comment on pwede si Jigs as a lawyer kasi mayro para sa report na
of land for campus and conservation. So, we'll hear it from the lawyer if it's unconstitutional or not.
In the absence of any court order, pronouncement, or judgment, the presumption of regularity subsists. So, we'll follow the operation of Tokhang until such time it will be considered null and void or void for being unconstitutional.
Yeah, kasi that's Oplan Tokhang is. Ano namin yun eh, flat of plan dito sa PNP, no? We'll not do anything that is unconstitutional and that violative of the law. So So, alam naman na natin sa BNP yun kung it violates the rights of the people. No? Hindi naman siguro gagawin yung ano yun, yung OPLA na yun kung talagang nagpa-violate siya ng human rights. There's nothing wrong. Na hindi ka papasukin talaga. Doon lang naman, now if you want to surrender, you go to the police station or to the city hall where you'll be made to fill out the form. Ganun. Ngayon, kung pumipirma doon sa affidavit, they have a counsel there na provided by the local government unit pag pumipirma sila ng affidavit. Wala naman tayong waiver na pinapasign sa kanila. Yung pinapasign sa kanila is like an undertaking at saka yung personal details nila for monitoring purposes. And that personal details are submitted to the barangay. No? Meron yung barangay, meron yung station, meron yung LGU. So just to monitor their activities. Remember, after they surrender, that doesn't end there. No? Weekly, minomonitor sila. Kaya nga yung iba-ibang cities dito sa Metro Manila, they have their own program to monitor itong mga surrenderers natin. Yung iba may sumba, yung iba may counseling, no? Yung iba naman undergoes training in coordination with TESDA. Or yung iba naman, nagpo-provide ng livelihood program.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you and good morning to everyone.